When I walked into that seventh grade classroom, I was carrying something a little bit weird. A homemade brainwave reading headset made from wires, tape, and a little hot glue. Most of the kids were laughing, but one skeptical 12-year-old raised his hand and asked a question. Can I try it? He slipped the headset on, watched his brainwaves dance on the screen. His eyes widened, and he said something that I would never forget. If my brain runs on electricity, can I rewire it? For me, that sentence did more than any textbook ever could, because that kid didn't just see his brain, he saw agency. And today, what I'll attempt to convince you of is exactly that. That's what neuroscience gives you. Not just the realization you have a brain, because hopefully we all do, but the realization that you can control it. Here's the problem. The educational system teaches kids how to read and write. It teaches them sometimes how to code. It forces us to memorize the Krebs cycle along with hundreds of other facts. But we don't learn the first thing about our own brain. Not just the four lobes, really, truly, how we think, how we feel, how we react. And that's kind of wild if you think about it, because everything good and bad about the world really involves the brain at some level. Love and compassion are just chemicals in the brain. Hatred and aggression and anger are also just brain regions talking to each other. And yet, most students can't explain why TikTok feels addictive or what chronic stress does, not just to our mood, but to our memory and attention. It's an educational blind spot. A 2021 study in Nature Neuroscience found that adolescents with a lower awareness of how their emotions influence their cognition are more likely to be diagnosed with depression and anxiety. But it's not just social media, it's life. A study in Science found that chronic stress doesn't just feel bad, it physically reshapes the architecture of the brain. It shrinks the prefrontal cortex, which is a part of the brain responsible for decision-making and emotional regulation, while strengthening the amygdala, your brain's fear and aggression center. Knowing that, would you still choose to pull that all-nighter? What if every decision we made was built on a foundational scientific understanding of how our brain works? We're handing students the most complex tool in the known universe, their brain, and giving them no instruction manual. That's not education. That's negligence. But okay, you're probably saying, maybe that's true, but nobody really knows much about their brain, right? So no harm done. Wrong. Let me make this urgent. You're not just missing out on how your brain works. The people that understand it are rewriting it for you. Algorithms are designed with one goal: hijack your attention neurochemically. A study in Nature Human Behavior found that social media platforms are structurally optimized to exploit reward prediction error, that spike of dopamine you get when you get a new like or video suggestion. Big companies literally have in-house neuroscientists whose job it is to exploit your attention, especially of adolescents. So what? Well, frequent digital multitasking correlates with a shrinkage in the anterior cingulate cortex, a region of the brain responsible for impulse control. As long as you allow this to continue, your attention is the product. Your emotions are the input, and your behavior is the experiment. Because if you don't understand your brain, people and the world around you will take advantage of that. So, what's the solution? Well, in my opinion, it's neuroscience. Not just as another cool elective, but as a core subject on par with English and math. Why? Well, because neuroscience is and will be the literacy of the 21st century. But what does that mean in real life? I taught a 10-year-old about dopamine. A week later, he came to me and said, "I finally get it. Fortnite gives me a hit, and I can control it." Another student said, "I realized anxiety isn't my brain doing anything to harm me. It's just protecting me." That's what happens when you put the power of science back in students' hands. They don't just feel more powerful, they are more powerful. And that power of neuroscience isn't just hypothetical. It's already transforming classrooms. A recent study examined neural feedback training in adolescents. When participants learned how to modulate their brain's activity using real-time data, they developed measurably stronger emotional regulation. In other words, simply just being aware of how their brain worked made them more in control, statistically. But here's the coolest part. Your brain is plastic. I mean, literally, we call this neuroplasticity. In a landmark study by Mertzig and colleagues in 2014, they found that this neurofeedback induces structural changes across multiple regions of the brain, the auditory cortex, the motor cortex, even the hippocampus, where new memories are encoded. In other words, you are never stuck with your current self, or identity, or emotions. You are a living construction site, always in flux. Now, with this information, there are a couple ways that we could react. You could live as a reactive, letting the environment and the world around you control your means, control your life, and control your brain. Or you could live intentionally, using what we know about the brain to shape itself. Now, for a second, let's imagine a world in which everyone lived as this latter intentional person. Well, if more people understood the amygdala's response to fear, we'd stop building so much hate. If more people realized that trauma physically reshapes the brain, we'd stop judging so much and start caring. And if we valued attention as a finite neural resource, we'd stop designing systems that were built to destroy it. Because if we recognize that our friends, our family, our neighbors, and ourselves are just signals and cells firing in predictable, specific, and repeatable patterns, we could recognize those patterns, interrupt the bad ones, and let the good ones thrive. That is the power of neuroscience. So, what can we do today? Learn the language of your mind. Recognize the moment that your attention or emotions are hijacked. When you feel that indescribable hatred at your friend for losing that round of pickleball or your 50 Instagram reels deep into your bed rotting session. And return to the question that kid asked me. If my brain runs on electricity, can I rewire it? Yes, and when you do, your brain will no longer be a limit on your mind. You possess the most powerful device in the known universe, a device consisting of 86 billion neurons, trillions of connections, capable of rewiring itself on thought alone. So let's stop ignoring it and start understanding it. Thank you.